I'm Dzebam Godlove from Kamerun, one of the 54 countries in Africa, and I am here in Germany for a volunteer year at Solidarity International in Berlin. The weltwärts-Programm, it's a program that allows young adults below the age of 28 to go abroad. It started in 2008 with young Germans going to other parts of the world, and then with a lot of critics, because we cannot call something an exchange program while other people from the other parts of the world are not coming to Germany as well. So with a lot of critics from the German population and some other stakeholders, the German government said, okay, the partners from other countries can also come to Germany, and I am the second batch of those who are coming to Germany for this program. And one of my activities is with the theater group, the Spielwut Spielmarkt, which is under this education program, of course. And there we work with non-Germans, and we try to use the stage and, you know, Forum Theater of Augusto Boal, we try to use the stage to express a theme or a major theme, and what we want to change, or what we see that it's a problem in the society. So we meet every Tuesdays and share our ideas. And another very interesting project that for my 1 year I've been quite involved in is Draufsicht, and we do global learning topics tour as well. And we do a lot of critical videos and discuss every fortnight and bring up new ideas. In the program, we have to come up with a yearly project, and so I decided to come up with this film, which is going to look at breaking stereotypes or contribution to breaking stereotypes, and also looking at a critical point of the weltwärts program. And from my own perspective, I realized with the other volunteers, discussing with them, there is this one particular perspective that most of the volunteers, they don't really meet their expectations, because probably somebody wants to be to study law or to be a businessman or so, and tries to take a volunteer year to improve on the field, and then probably the person comes to Germany and finds himself in the kindergarten, and then there is no rapport, there's no raison d'etre between these two. In order to really find out about the critical approach towards the weltwärts program, my mentor, Daniel Weyand, and I, we visited Christina Conzi from the organization Glocal. She wrote her PhD dissertation on the North-South program from the post-colonial perspective, and we found out from her that the biggest problems of the program is really connected with the discourse of development.
Genau, also ich glaube, es wird so sehr deutlich in der Gegenüberstellung wieder. Während eben die deutschen Freiwilligen mit Modernität verbunden werden, mit so technical knowledge, mit sehr gebildet sein. Und vor allem ein wichtiger Faktor ist, glaube ich, Entwicklung bringend. Also wenn man sich das anschaut und was für Projekten die arbeiten, sie sind halt, und das ist ja das Schwierige überhaupt, es bewegt sich alles in diesem Entwicklungsdiskurs. Und auf der anderen Seite, bei den Südfreiwilligen, dass sie als tatsächlich weniger modern dargestellt werden und vor allem fast wie eine Art von der Verkörperung von Unterentwicklung. Das heißt, nur dass ich aus einem Südland komme und bin dann quasi ich da in, wo auch immer, in der Schule und so weiter, dadurch sollen Menschen plötzlich entwicklungspolitische Themen kennenlernen. Das heißt, während eben, wie gesagt, die einen Entwicklung bringen, bringen die anderen wie in Unterentwicklung mit sich, um jetzt mal in den ganz alten Begriffen zu bleiben.
I also took our time to visit other friends in their various organizations and find out what they are doing there, because it's really quite also a positive thing for volunteers to leave from their countries and make an experience, because I believe that you will never go back to your country as you came. I visited Linda Gobesen at Brotwitveld she is a human rights activist in Cameroon from the Northwest region, and she is very much involved with girl child and traditional practices.
Germany, just like Cameroon, have issues with the emancipation of women and girls. Just like Cameroon, Germany has the pay gap, the equality pay gap. You know, women are not paid as much as men are paid. And just because there's a female chancellor, or just because Bread for the World is headed by a woman, doesn't mean that all the women in Germany are emancipated. There are still a lot of gaps to be filled, and there are still a lot of efforts to be made to ensure that women are as empowered or are on the same wavelength like men. But in as much as all of these gaps need to be filled in Germany, it's very impressive that women in Germany have come a long way. It's impressive to see that women are in a lot of leading positions, and girls, just like boys, are attending school. But I want to call it a balance sheet as well, because there are also a lot of best practices that I'm bringing from Cameroon to Germany. I think that more women in Cameroon are represented in the parliament than in Germany. More women in Cameroon are in leadership positions than in Germany. And this is really impressive, because, you know, when you look at developing countries, you always think that the best things are in developed countries. But to analyze and realize that Cameroonian women in decision-making positions in the Senate, in the parliament, are more than the women in Germany, that is totally impressive for me.
And then this was a very good friend of mine from Georgia, of course, Tamazi. I took our time to also visit him and discuss with him, which I find quite interesting, because Tamaz is one of the people that wants a very peaceful world and wants everybody to live without any stereotypes. You being here, what are the stereotypes that probably you've been able, or you've succeeded to really broke them so far?
The most important stereotype for me was that I was thinking that Europe is absolutely free of homophobia and transphobia and biphobia. And when I came to Berlin, I was with my friend in the U-Bahn. We were going to Halloween party, and we had some special makeup, and for 30 minutes we had 3 cases of homophobia and transphobia in U-Bahn. Yeah, then after a while I discovered that that was not only one day, and everywhere there is the homophobia, yeah. Everywhere. So, but it depends on the level. But it was it made me so sad first time, because I did not expect, and it was really big disappointment for me here.
One day I was in the train station and I have to move to one place, but I forget the name, the place that I have to go. So I take the train in the wrong direction, and I was completely lost. And I tried to ask like 3 or 4 times for help. And the people, some of them was with their music, some of them was reading. So just to try to go there to interrupt someone, it's like to invade the space of somebody else. And I feel so frustrated, and I was like, what I can do now? Nobody helped me.
So when you look at the colonial history, you see that the European countries colonized the so-called Global South today. And with this colonial history, you know, there is this paternalistic relationship. And it's really quite hard for volunteers from the Global South to bring up something to the North, as probably this is what I am bringing to share with you, because it's like osmosis, where a stronger solution is pulling the weaker one. So there is this history for years that had been in the minds of people.
Deutschland versucht ja immer, sich als sehr weltoffen und diskriminierungsfrei vielleicht sogar darzustellen. und ermöglicht es jetzt sogar Menschen aus dem globalen Süden hierher zu kommen, um Freiwilligendienst zu machen, während sie gleichzeitig ganz stark dazu hinarbeiten, dass die Grenzen Europas komplett abgeschottet werden. Und diese Gleichzeitigkeit, also da hat für mich das Programm eine Funktion, nämlich eine, einen guten Anstrich zu geben und fast also zu legitimieren, zu sagen, wir, was wollt ihr denn? Die können doch jetzt auch alle hierher kommen.
I remember the first, my first week in Europe and my first week in Bread for the World. I had a conversation with few persons who asked me questions about why I was in Germany, and I had some very strange responses when they heard that I was going to be a volunteer. There was the reaction of, how is an African volunteer going to cope with the standard of Europe and working in Europe? I've been working with a lot of colleagues, supporting them through their own projects, doing a lot of presentations, and I've organized my own seminars, you know. I've been able to work harder than any other person probably thought, you know, before coming to Germany. So this is impressive for me, and I hope it's impressive for every other person who had stereotypes about Cameroonians or people coming from the Global South to work in Germany.
If you come to another country, doesn't mean that you have to do the things like you do in your country all the time, because also it's part of this, you have to adapt the part that you have to with you and the part that they want. For example, if I have to be punctual, I do it. And also it's important for me. And I mean, these kind of stereotypes are not very important. The most important is that if you do your work well, you break all of them.
I had several times really big difficulties here, and I was also thinking about leaving the program. But leaving the program is the easiest solution. Yeah, I have problems and okay, I'm going. I think so. I had lots of problems here, but the main thing is that I did not give up, and I started to solve these problems. Now I am much, much more confident, and now I am who I am, what I want, what I am doing, what I want to do and what I will do. So that's the most important thing, and I'm really sure about all of this stuff.
I live with a German family, and every time my guest sister always asks me, when I come back at the end of the day, was hast du heute gemacht? Which is very much a very important question, because it makes me try to work on my balance sheet every day and know that I have to be productive or have to do something that it's of value, because I know that each day I go back home, she'll ask me, was hast du heute gemacht? So, and it's very much something great that I'll be taking back to my country. I met people that we had different orientation, and I had different cultural differences, and at the end of the day we had to build some of these differences, and we came up with satisfactory solutions on my own part. And I think if all volunteers can make these experiences and make greater and better experiences, keeping cultural differences apart and being open to learn new things, I think it's going to be so wonderful.